Here are my top 100 favorite films of all time from 60 to 51. Safdie Brothers directing Uncut Gems with Adam Sandler, releasing in 2019. I think this is a really, this is arguably has the best Adam Sandler performance of his career. It's a very anxiety inducing, but that's a great thing about their films. Very, you know, a lot of suspense. I think there's a lot of great editing and character choices within this film, and I love this style and soundtrack, so yeah. Scorsese's Taxi Driver from 1966, I believe. Of course, with great Robert De Niro, Travis Bickle finding his corrupt views within New York City. This is a classic, one of the best 70 films, films from the 1970s. Yeah. Kung Fu Panda, released in 2008 from DreamWorks. Probably my favorite Jack Black performance. It's very inspiring to people who want to fulfill their dream and train in the arts of Kung Fu. So that's pretty cool. Batman 89 from Tim Burton revitalized the great character of Batman for a lot of new audiences and generations. Reinvented the Batman character and making him more darker. Jack Nicholson's great performance as the Joker. So, yeah. George Miller's 2015 Mad Max Fury Road. It's a great like reboot slash sequel. Requel? No, nah, that's bad. Bad joke. Tom Hardy as Mad Max. You have the great production design, great bombastic action. It's really wild and mad and fun and dangerous at the same time. Nolan's Interstellar from 2014, a great sci-fi film with Matthew McConaughey. It's a very, there's a lot of intellect behind it, and there's also a great cinematography, great, fantastic score from Hans Zimmer. Great. Everything is Awesome. Yeah. The Lego Movie from 2014 from Phil Lord and Chris Miller. It's very imaginative with a brand. I mean, since you know Legos, they're awesome. Legos are awesome. Great voice acting, really fun and inventive with a heartfelt message. So, Peter Jackson's first installment of the Lord of the Rings trilogy with Fellowship of the Ring. Elijah Wood, Ian McKellen, other great actors from 2001. Great fantasy startup of this franchise. Great production design, great action, and again, the Twin Towers. not the Twin Towers, no. The Two Towers from 2002, the sequel to Fellowship of the Ring. It's again a great follow-up. We continue following Frodo in the Hobbit's journey, and more chaos ensues. So, yeah, better than the first film, Kung Fu Panda 2, again with Jack Black from 2011. Continues the story of Poe, learns more about his past with another great villain portrayed by Gary Oldman. So, yeah, great action, heartfelt message. Yeah.